So now I want to explain what it means to control for a variable. So let's say, for example, we want to find out, does attendance predict exam grades? Controlling for employment. That is, for students just having a full-time job, explain the relationship between attendance and exam grades. And so controlling for is one expression, one set of words that you'll see for this. But you'll also see, does attendance predict exam grades, correcting for employment? And that's referring to the same thing that I'll be going through in a second. Or does attendance predict exam grades, taking employment into account? So these are different terms people use to refer to this exact same thing that we're going to be going through here in a second, which is, what does it mean to control for a variable in multiple regression? Let's say we collect our data and we have people's exam grades and their attendance, and we do the scatter plot. And it looks something like this. So there's a strong positive correlation between attendance and exam grade. If we do a simple regression, we would be able to predict exam grade based on somebody's attendance, right? Somebody comes in and they're right about here. We would predict this is their exam grade. And given the consistency in the previous data, it'd probably be a pretty accurate prediction. So now what we want to do for this example, let's say we also know, we also ask these exact same participants if they have a full-time job or not. So we'll say that people either have a full-time job or they're completely unemployed, which means they're probably focusing a lot on being a student, right? And so now we're going to consider two different scenarios. So we'll call this scenario number one. And here, we're still going to have the exact same people and the exact same data, exam score, or exam grade, exam score, and it's the same, and attendance down here. All right. There was 20 people here, and we'll say that I'll use red for people with a full-time job and green for people with no job, right? So this is employment status for these students. Let's say we do the scatter plot for these folks, and we find that these exact same folks, it's not drawn exactly, but imagine I just color-coded these and put it over here. If this is what the data looks like, then really what has happened is that people without a job had better attendance and better exam scores. And people who were very busy outside of their classwork weren't able to attend class very much, and they also had lower exam scores. So in this case, attendance does not predict exam grades controlling for employment. And one way you could tell is if you look just at the green alone, right, there's not a positive or a negative correlation between attendance and exam. Right, the best fit line is probably just a flat line. And if you look just at the red, if I drew it right, there shouldn't be a positive or a negative correlation. There should be no correlation at all. And so with a multiple regression, if you control for employment, in this case, attendance would have a B or even a beta of zero. Because when you've controlled for employment, there's no relationship left between attendance and exam score. The relationship is completely explained by people's employment status. And all that's happened is people who have a full-time job attend less, class and they got worse exam scores, and people with no job were able to attend more class and they got better exam scores. So in this case, employment could be a third variable explanation for the initial observed explanation, right? So remember, third variable looks like this. In this case, it would be employment. It's explaining the relationship between exam scores and attendance, right? And it's very plausible that people who are full-time employed, that causes them to attend less class, and it could also cause them to do worse on their exam scores. For example, this relationship here could be mediated by time studying, hour studying, right? It could be that people who are working full-time, they don't have time to study, and that's what's causing their exam grade to go down. Right, this could be the case, even if attending class is so useless that it itself doesn't increase exam grades. Right, so this would be a scenario where in multiple regression, attendance no longer predicts exam scores, controlling for employment. And so controlling for employment, employment could be a third variable explanation for this initial observation, for this initial relationship. Right. So that's one way that this data could have shaken out. Another thing that could have happened with the exact same data again, and the exact same employment information, and the same 20 people, it could have been the case that people with a full-time job and people with no job. So I'm hoping to draw this exactly like this and this. And basically, I'm hoping to just color code these 20 people here. And here, controlling for employment. All right, so now we can just look at the red folks, right? There's a strong positive correlation still for the red colored dots. And for the green colored dots, for the people with no job, there's also a strong positive correlation between attendance and exam score. If this is how your results end up working out, then attendance does predict exam grades when controlling for employment. Because across every level of the third variable, employment, across every level, the relationship is still there. Here, across every level of employment, there is no relationship, right? And notice that multiple regression will force this slope and this slope to be the same, and this slope and this slope to be the same. It's an assumption of multiple regression that these relationships are exactly the same. You can do some more advanced regression where you can allow those slopes to vary. But for now, we'll stick with the simple case here. Where they are not allowed to vary. So the example I just went through had a grouping variable for employment. Either people worked full-time or they didn't work at all. But you can also control for variables that have lots of different levels, right? And so now we'll stick with employment, but we'll allow people's values for employment to vary more. And we'll just go through the exact same scenarios. So we'll have our scenario one here. Right, and we still have our exam grade as what we're predicting, and we're still predicting it with attendance, right? And so what we'll do here is we'll say, so these are folks who work 30 to 40 hours per week. And we'll say these are folks who work 20 to 30 hours per week. And these are folks who work 10 to 20 hours per week. And up here are folks who work 0 to 10 hours per week. So when you're controlling for a variable, what you do is you look at the relationship between the variables of interest across every level of the other variable. So we look at it here, and here, and here, and here, right? And we see if there's a positive correlation for each of those levels. And for here, I tried to draw it so that there's no correlation here, and no correlation here, no correlation here, and no correlation here. So if this is what the data were like, then attendance no longer predicts exam grade controlling for employment, right? So what's happening here is people who didn't work very much, they were able to attend a lot of class, and they got really good grades on their exam. And people who worked a lot weren't able to attend very much class, and they didn't do very well in the class, right? And so, and it could have been the case that what's happening is people that worked a lot, they weren't able to study, right? They weren't able to attend class. They were too busy to actually focus on the class, and that's why their exam grade is low. So let's do the scenario where when you control for employment like this, there still is a relationship. Scenario two. So we still got attendance predicting exam grade. All right, and so now I'll keep the overall relationship, and I'm just trying to color code them, but now I'm going to try to keep a positive correlation between attendance and exam grade at every level of employment. So let's say it looks like that for, this is people that work 30 to 40 hours per week. And this is people that work 20 to 30. This is people that work 10 to 20. This is people that work 0 to 10. Right here, what I tried to draw is a positive relationship between attendance and exam grade at every level of employment. So in this case, attendance does predict exam grade controlling for employment, because this relationship holds across all the different levels of employment. And so here, employment can't explain the observed relationship between attendance and exam grades, whereas here, employment can explain this relationship. And so this is a really important kind of way of thinking about multiple regression. This is the main reason people use multiple regression, is to see if a relationship holds when controlling for a third variable.